Hey guys, actually I picked these up a year ago, and the story behind them is I was taking a shortcut through an alley downtown Hamilton, and someone had chucked these pile of records out, and they were sitting in dirt, and there was actually something growing out of one of the covers. The covers were deteriorated to the point where they were just paste. There was nothing you could do with them, and I figured, you know what, I'm going to grab them. Bring them home, clean them up, see if I can get them to play again. And hopefully they're not warped, because it was in the middle of summer. And they look like they've been sitting out there for months, if not longer. I'm actually glad I did. Talk about a trip through time. unfortunately, like I said, I couldn't save the sleeve, so I grabbed these ones off of Amazon. We got Steppenwolf. Can show you the condition of some of them. I haven't cleaned them all. But they do play pretty good considering their condition. See, there's a lot of filth. Side one. This one was made in Canada by RCA Limited. It doesn't have the date on it, though. Anybody who's really into albums will know what time period that is. Dunhill. Well, I'm guessing it's pretty old. And this is one and two, live performance. Well, let's make sure there's nothing else in here. I ran out of sleeves, so one of them, a few of them might have two records in it. Yeah, these haven't been cleaned. ZZ Top. I don't know if that one's been cleaned or not. Let's take a look. It has been, well, it's not too bad, but it hasn't been cleaned. Oh, this side's even worse. So you can see the stains for where it was all gooey and everything else. Like I said, they were in pretty rough shape. Styx, the Grand Illusion. Not really a Styx fan, but it's trippy still listening to it. That's not bad. Not really scratched up too much. It's a real shame that they left them out. Pink Floyd, The Wall. I think there's two of them in here. Come on. Just hard to do this with one hand. Yeah, these aren't bad. I gotta get two different sleeves for them, but they do need to be cleaned. Surprisingly, the labels survived. Well, I totally don't get that, because they were sopping wet. What's this one here? The famous Charisma label, I guess, whatever. Selling England by the Pound. Oh, it's Genesis. Boy. Okay. Cool. The shape of the record hasn't been cleaned. It's still got some mold on it. It's playable. There's another one in here. Touchstone sound recording, Night and Daydream. Most of these are printed in Canada. I have no idea what that is. Oh, I'm going to play it and find out later. This one I just cleaned. It still probably needs more. Burton Cummings. Jeez. When I played this, I was like, wow. But it's in great shape. It's very clean. It's got, I think that's light stains on the label, but the records are mint. That one turned out pretty good. It's really a shame I couldn't save the sleeves. April Wine, Harder, Faster. Doesn't really need to be cleaned. Light scratch as well. Major scratch right there, but it'll still play through that, I'm sure. Toto. That one I just cleaned. More sticks. You can still see the shades of mold on there. Haven't cleaned that one. Seriously considering getting a cleaner, but then I hear some people saying that they're not that good. You can do it better with your by hand and everything else. So There's another one I just finished cleaning. It's got some light scratches, but they're not. It doesn't affect the record at all. Boston. This one is pretty trippy playing. 1976. And Joe Cocker. This one I just cleaned. And it sounds pretty good. I just finished listening to Feeling All Right, which is kind of a trip. Like I said, it's got some light scratches in it. But nothing, you know, I'm not getting any pops or anything. So that's pretty cool. Yeah, I figured I'd share that. That was a weird find. It's very rare that I'll find a pile of albums sitting in an alley, rotting away. I mean, they could have taken to a shop and tried to pawn them off, just at least give them away. You know what I mean? They couldn't get any money for them, just to keep them in circulation. But they just let them rot, which is depressing. But I managed to save them. I'll add them to my collection. Almost, you know, they're not worth anything because there's no sleeves. But hey, it's still a trip to being able to drop something this old and listen to it. After all this time, it's pretty cool. Later, guys.